Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how to make a mini mixed media canvas using just magazines, texts, pictures as inspiration, because very often I find that getting started is the hardest bit. Once you're on a roll with what you want to do, it just seems to flow, but actually putting the first pieces down and thinking up what am I going to do today can often be the hardest bit. So what I've got here is a canvas board, all right, and some cartridge paper. It's about 190 GSM card, if I believe. I'll just double check that. Yeah, 190 gram per square meter. Okay, and that's a good weight to use with acrylics, etc., and other mediums. So that's going to be where my design goes, and this is going to end up my support and my frame for it. Okay, so now we've got that ready. Pop your canvas to one side, and I'm just going to prep this with some gesso. There we go, now I can put that to one side and leave that to dry. Okay, so bring my canvas back. We know it's a little bit smaller all the way around. So, all I've done before starting this video is to grab some words. Now, I saw this in a magazine in my country kitchen. I thought, yep, I like that. So, I'm going to cut that out. Now, you can have it separate words. So you could have country from one magazine page and kitchen from another and have it like that. And I've got some others I'll show you a bit later that I've done recently. Or otherwise you can have it all as one. So I'm just going to cut these so they've got nice sharp edges to it. So it's in my country kitchen. Okay, and I like this. This has got some plates and bits. Now for this, I actually want a torn edge. Because in the end, I want my words to stand out a bit more, and straight edges will always stand out better. All right, so I've torn around that. So no idea, like I say, how it's gonna go at the moment. Okay, so I've had a play with my design, and what I've come up with is this. So I've got my paper back in front of me now as my sizing. So this is the sort of thing I'm going for. I ended up splitting up my words. Okay, and I sort of something along this sort of line. I think I have that under there, but touching this one. It's quite good if some of your pieces connect to each other. You don't want lots of little bits of paper just stuck randomly around your piece. It's good for them to connect. So they're overlapping, that's overlapping, and then I've got these little plates which I love, and they're going to go there. So I think for me that's quite pleasing to the eye. I think I'll bring that down. I don't want them lining up at the top. So something along that line. So once you've got your design, you can then think about your colours. Now you need two colours plus white. So blue, this one's called Sea Swirl. I think you can get these individually as well, these colours. And this one is Husk. Okay, so I'm taking a smaller brush in a moment, so I've got that ready. But for this bit, I quite like to use just an old sort of credit card, that sort of thing. So take some colour. Thank you. the next thing I want to do is I want to push back some bits of my design. I'm going to do that and bring other bits forward. I'm going to do that by adding a bit more white. Okay, so cleaned off my flat brush, grab a bit of titanium white, and I'm just literally going to look at this and think, let's play, put a bit more white here, look. Okay. Something like that. So you can see already it's starting to pull together as a design. Love it already, it's cool. Okay, so we've got some extra white on. Again, we can always add a bit more. We are going to be putting a bit of shadow around these words. So sometimes it's quite nice. And like here, I haven't got much overlapping this word, so I'll just bring a bit more white in, just on that edge, just so that it sort of, it's pulled in together. This one's got a bit over it. There's a bit here. So just make sure each of your pictures has got something, a little bit of white just there on part of it, but obviously not covering all of your background. You want some of your colours from your background to pull through. Right, so the next thing we want to do is to put this little bit of shadow that I was talking about around the words. But I've always used Jo Sonja mediums with the paints, so that's what I'm most comfortable with. So a little bit of glazing medium. And then I've got a 3/8 angle brush. Now, I much prefer angle brushes. You could use a flat brush, which is obviously what we used before. You have to be careful that you use the right size brush for where you want your float to be, for the simple reason that if I was to float around here with a bigger brush, as I'm blending out my colours on my tile, it could end up travelling further across the brush and it would be an actual bigger float around my words. So for this size here, this almost 3/8 almost would be the right size. With an angle brush, you load the paint onto the long side of the brush, and then that's the side that is closest and where your darkest shadow is. So you wet the brush, dab it dry. Okay, load up a little bit of medium. Okay, you don't want it swimming in it, you're just picking up some on both sides and blending it out a little bit. Corner into the paint to pick up some. Okay, never more than a third. If you needed to pick up more than a third because of the size of the shadow, you need to move to a bigger brush. Now that may well be too much paint. I won't know really until I come to the tile here. So I then go backwards and forwards on the spot, pushing down, handles right upright, look. Because it's pushing off the excess paint and it's given me a flow. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is turn this so I'm comfortable and pull this colour. If it's too much paint, just dab it on the towel. Pull this colour around on the background next to the text. And you see that? So there we have like a float of colour, okay, around, and then I can come down this side with it. I can go back to my tile, go backwards and forwards, pick a bit more up. And then I'm going to do the same around in my as well. And this will make basically the words pop forward a little bit. Okay, so I've now used a bit of shadow around my text to push my text forward. Okay, so my pictures now become more of the background. Okay, that looks good. I'm pleased with that. So I can wash my brush and get that dry.
Just let me.
finished piece. And press it down. So there we go. All right, so I hope you've enjoyed watching that. Hope the lighting's all right for you, and have a go. That's the main thing. Have a go at home and try just different things. I had not planned this at all, other than finding some words in the pictures before I started it. And you can see how laying it out while I was filming and choosing the colours and everything really, and where I was going to put things, and the, with the white paint and everything, how as a whole it will work. See you again soon. Bye.